Hi, I'm George Pearson, and these are just a few examples from some of the training videos I have here on YouTube. Now, when you're working with the training, following along the training, if you want to get the materials I used in the training, just go to the description down below and click on the link that's at the top of the description, and this will take you to a page where you can download the materials. Please subscribe, click the like button, and of course, always share on Facebook, Twitter, or wherever. I really appreciate that. Okay, let's go ahead and get started with the video. In this how-to, we'll be making this top secret rubber stamp effect. It's pretty straightforward, but there are a few little tricks in here that will help make this very easy to do and easy to change in the future. Okay, let's just start off here with a brand new file. I'm just going to close that out. And I'll do a new file. And I have this one set at the default Photoshop Elements size 6x4 at 300 pixels per inch for print quality. And there we go. Now the first thing we want to do is to create our text. So let's grab our type tool in here. And I have this set for stencil standard bold. Any good solid type fits will work out for this look. I just kind of like this one. But anything will work out fine. Now the color I've chosen here, the red, this is the CMYK red. It's not quite as bright as the regular RGB red, and I think it looks a little bit more like a stamp that you or a stamp color that you would use with red. So there you go. It's the CMYK red, size 36. Everything else here doesn't really matter on this one. Let's go ahead and type this in, putting it in all caps, of course. There we go. Top secret. And I'll just put it about in the center of the page. The next thing we need is to have our double outlines on this, and those are made using the rounded rectangle over here. I'll set this to white, set our color to white, there we are, and unconstrained. You can do it from center or not, it doesn't really matter. I'll just pull it from the left hand side. Now to see this, I'm going to hide the background so we have just kind of a clear background, and I want to put this underneath the top secret text. Let's kind of grab it like that. There we go. Now the rounded corners I have on this one set at 50 pixels. You can kind of see it. There it is. So that 50 gives us that nice roundness in there. So it's pretty wide, pretty large round for that effect. And I just, you know, freehanded the position on that. You can do whatever you like to make it look about right. You can see it's about three times the height, maybe a little less. And about one letter space on the side, about the same space as you have in here on the two sides. Somewhere around in there is fine. Now we need to have the red outline on this, and that's done with a layer style. So layer and layer style, style settings, and click on stroke. Now the size I have for this one is 16. The position is outside. And the color is the same red as that. Easy way to do that, click on the color box over here. That gives you a little eyedropper, and just grab the color right off of the letters. There we go. So the color is an exact match. Okay, that's our inside outline. And I'm just going to call this one inside, like that, inside stroke, since we're using a stroke for that. Let's copy this, just drag this up here to the new layer, and I'll pull it down underneath. This is going to be my outside stroke, so I'll just type in our lettering here. Not really sure why it just canceled out there. There we go. Doesn't want to do that. There it is. Sometimes Photoshop Elements is a little weird. That's good. So inside stroke, outside stroke. Now the outside stroke is larger than the inside stroke. And we'll do that by first resizing this shape. So image and resize scale right there. Bring that up. Now notice down here we have constrained proportions. Uncheck that. And we have a width and a height. I'm going to change the width and height both to 120%, and let's see where that gets us. Well, then adjust from there. This will at least get it out of the line. Okay, here's 120%. That looks good for the top and bottom. That's about where I want that, but left and right is wrong. So let's bring the width down a little bit. Let's try it at 110. That's still too much. Let's bring it down to 105. Looks about right. It's a little bit offset, but that's what I want, so I'll click OK, and then using the arrow keys, cursor keys on my keyboard, I'll just kind of tap that over a little bit. Okay, so there's the two outlines. We now need to make the outside outline thicker. So go to the outside stroke, double click where it says FX, brings back up the style settings, and then change the size to 29. There it is, and that gives us a thicker outside. Now I don't want to have this white in here because we want to be able to see our background coloration. Let's bring that in at this point. I'll make a new background by clicking on a new layer here above our background. Let's fill this with kind of a tan color. Just come over here into the yellows and choose something up in here someplace. It doesn't have to be critical. This anything in here will be fine. I'm doing this where I'm just at the top of the orangish kind of bit there, where I'm down below the yellow and about one third of the way in on the left hand side. And let's fill that layer. There we go. Now you can see we have white in here. I want to get rid of that white. But I also want to be able to come back and change these if I want to in the future. And the way you do that is by making copies of these. So grab our first one, copy that, and then hide the original. Notice where it says copy. Do the second one down here, make a copy of that, hide the original. Now, on the text, right-click and choose Simplify Layer. Notice that the FX has just gone away. So it has now put that red outline in as part of the actual graphic. Do the same thing for the outside stroke copy, right-click, Simplify Layer, there we go. Now I can use my magic wand, click inside, that selects the white, hit the delete key, and that gets rid of the white. Go up here to our other copy, do the exact same thing, click inside, delete key, and there we go. We can just deselect that. Okay, that looks pretty good. Let's see if I can move that outside over just a touch more. And that's about the best it's going to do. Okay, so there's the basic layout on this. Let's zoom in a bit, get a little better view of what's going on here. I'm just going to dock this at the top. There we go. Okay, so far so good. We have our nice red outline shapes and our red text. We now need to distress this a bit by knocking out a little bit of this, making it look like it's an older stamp and not a new stamp. Now to do this next trick, I'm going to be combining these layers into a new layer. Let's first hide the background layer. So we only have the two outlines showing and the text. Click on the text, it's our top layer up here, and then hold down the Control, Alt, and Shift keys and hit the E key. Let me bring that up so you can see what I'm talking about here. There we go, Control, Alt, Shift, and the E key. Doesn't matter, upper or lowercase, doesn't matter. On the Mac, it's Command, Option, Shift, E key. Same thing. So there we go. I'll just use that keyboard shortcut like that. And what it does is it combines the visible layers, that's this layer, and this layer, into a new layer. So it's a merge layer to a new layer, and it leaves these layers alone, which is what I want. I want to have all the stuff left here in case I want to go back in the future, change the text, change the sizes, whatever. I have all that stuff protected. Okay, now I'll hide everything. I can bring back up the background coloration. There we go. So there's our text layer up here. I'm just going to type in, I'll call this one stamp. That's my stamp layer. Okay, let's now distress this. Change the colors over here back to the default colors and put white at the front so you can see what we're doing. Let's make a new layer above our stamp layer right there and grab the brush tool. Now on the brush tool, I am using this brush right here. It's called Chalk Dark. It says 50 underneath of it. And this is in the Natural Brushes 2 set. So if your brushes are at the default brushes, which is like this, just click on the drop down, come down to the Natural Brushes 2. And at the very top there is this brush called Chalk Dark. That's the one that you want. Okay, so Chalk Dark, have it at 50. We now need to bring this size up. The size I used was 250, so I'll just do that. There you go. Nice big brush size. Now we're not going to be painting with this, we're going to be stamping with it. So let's go right over here. I'm going to click a couple of times like that. It comes in pretty solid. Let's now come down to brush settings and pull that around a bit. That rotates the brush right there. Little brush rotate. And I'll come in here and do a little click right there and do one over here someplace. Let's rotate the brush around some more for some variation, and I'll do something in here at the top. Maybe kind of overlap it right there. This is just a bit of an artistic bit. You know, just do whatever feels right for you. A couple in there, and a little one right down here. Just adding a few of these little spots. Let's just do one more. I'll rotate it clear around, and I'll put something right across the top of the letters in there. Okay, so just these white spots just sitting on top of the text. Looks pretty bad right now, but that's fun. That's exactly what I want. Now, let's just change this one here. I'll call it chalk spots. Now hold the control key down and click on the icon, and that selects those shapes just like that. Now come down to the stamp and actually hide that layer. There we go. So just the selections are showing. Come down to the stamp, hit the delete key, and it deletes those, erases those from that layer. Let's now just deselect that. There we go. And that distresses the effect. It looks like it's an older stamp. Now the last thing I want to do is I want to rotate this. Before I rotate, I'm going to make a copy of this one. Just drag it up to the new layer button like that. Hide that one, and I'll rotate the copy. That way I can always go back to my straight version if I need to, for whatever reason, if I want to change things around. Of course, I always have everything else down here is saved, so I can always go back to my originals if I want to recreate any part of this process. Okay, to rotate, come just in outside the corner here. You can see it, get that kind of a curved arrow. Grab that, give it a little twist, make it about 12 degrees. You can see it right down here. I'll do negative 12 to be exact on that. Choose OK. And there we go. There's our top secret distressed stamp. Now, if you're not happy with the distressing, just go up to this layer and you can erase, you know, some of these white spots, put in different white spots. You can play around with that to get just the look that you want. If you aren't happy with this at all, just make a new copy of this by deleting those layers. Come down here, show the outline layers in the text again, and do that same Control Alt Shift plus E key to make a new copy, and then do a new stamp layer. That's why I always try to protect things by making safety levels in here, saving our levels and just hiding those. We can always go back a few steps if we need to very, very easily. But there it is. That's how you do a distressed stamp effect. Thank you for watching this special Photoshop photography project video. Don't forget to subscribe so that you will get first notice of new project videos in the future. Just click on this link right here where it says subscribe here. You can get all 12 project videos in this series, along with 26 special videos demonstrating the tools and techniques that I used in these projects, by clicking on this link right down here. And then thank you again for watching this